गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डील विथ वन इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक ऑफ आवर सिलेबस रिलेटेड टू द राइटिंग स्किल सेक्शन. टाइटल ऑफ दिस टॉपिक इज लेटर राइटिंग. डू यू नो देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ लेटर्स फॉर 12th स्टैंडर्ड बोर्ड एग्जामिनेशन इज कंसर्न. फॉर्मल लेटर, इनफॉर्मल लेटर्स. सो इन टूडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न हाउ टू ड्राफ्ट फॉर्मल लेटर. हाउ वी ड्राफ्ट अ फॉर्मल लेटर, लेटर रिलेटेड टू द एप्लीकेशन सीकिंग लीव, addressing to the principal of our college, addressing to the class teacher of our college. Such type of letter can be asked to draft in your examination. So in today's lecture we are going to deal with what is the format of formal letter, letter to principal about seeking any kind of leave or any kind of concession, issuing identity card, issuing bona fide certificate. Topic may be the different one, but you should write a letter to the principal or a teacher according to the related format given to you. So students, today we are going to learn what is the format of formal letter, letter addressing to the principal. Suppose you have given a question to write a letter to the principal of our college seeking 5 days leave of absence. Give proper reason or give any reason. Or suppose your sister's marriage ceremony approaching near and you need 5 days or 1 week leave. So draft a letter to the principal of your college. Such type of letter can be asked in your question paper. Or another, your original identity card is misplaced somewhere, so you need new identity card. To issue new identity card, draft a letter to the principal of our college. Such type of question, such type of subject of letter given to you in your question paper. So how should we draft a formal letter addressing principal? We are going to learn first of all format of formal letter. And first, given here on the blackboard, sender's address. Means in sender's address you should write your name, your class, your division, your roll number and mention date. You should mention here your name, your class, division, your roll number and date. In a sender's address you should write these things: your name, such as Bharati Patil, then division 11th commerce A, 11th science A, or 12th commerce A, 12th commerce B, roll number is 56 120s. In this way you should draft here sender's address and then mention the date here. While drafting a date, while writing a date, you should also follow the pattern. Not only writing a date in traditional manner, but also write in this way: 26 September 2020. In this way you should write a date, proper date, at the end of the sender's address. So this is the first step we follow in letter writing. Then sender's address followed receiver's address. Second step given here in this format: sender's address followed the receiver's address. In the receiver's address you should write the name of the particular receiver, name and designation of the receiver to the principal, the name of the college, Anna Sai Gautam College, Mansur, or any other Chhatrapati Shivaji College, Satara, and also mention the PIN of the particular city, name of the city and PIN also mention here. So remember, in the sender's receiver's address, you should write name and designation of the receiver, then name of the college and name of the city and PIN also referred here. Then in a formal letter, you should write the exact subject. Subject is a very important part of this letter. To write the exact subject is very important while drafting formal letter. You should write to issue new identity card. You should write to give or permit leave of absence, to give me sick leave. So in this way you should write exact subject at the subject place. After subject, what is the next step? Salutation. In the letter writing, what is important to begin a letter with a proper salutation. Proper salutation means respected sir, dear sir we should use, but here we should use respected sir, because these people who are addressing, these are well qualified, knowledgeable people, and that is why they should be given proper respect. So use respected sir salutation. So these are the four steps. Once again I repeat these four steps. What is the four steps we are going to follow? Here, sender's address. Suppose in this way you should write a sender's address. In this way you should draft the sender's address. Saroj Party, standard 12A, roll number 35, date means you should mention 26 September 2020. So this is, in this way you should draft the sender's address. And after sender's address, you should come to the next term part of the letter, that is the receiver's address. Along with the margin of your page, you should write receiver's address to the principal, name of the college you should mention here, name of city. In this way you should write name and designation of the receiver and address of the receiver, name and designation of receiver and address of the receiver. So this is receiver's address. Then receiver's address follows subject. Receiver's address follows subject. In subject, you should state exact subject. To issue a new identity card. New identity card. This is the exact subject you should also mention. And then fourth important step of formal letter, after mentioning the subject, you should begin a letter with a proper salutation. Proper salutation, what we begin with the proper salutation? Respected sir and dear sir. You can use only two these words for a proper salutation. Respected sir or dear sir, In this way, you should write half a letter. Now, next stage or next part of the letter. After salutation, you come to the next part of the letter, that is the main body of the letter, main structure of the letter. And in this main structure of the letter, we should write in the first paragraph. Here given first paragraph. In this first paragraph, you should begin like this. I am, you should mention also here name, Saroj Patil, studying in your college, 12th commerce. My roll number is 31 or 35. And I have been regular sincere student throughout the year. But unfortunately, my original identity card misplaced somewhere. Unfortunately, my original identity card misplaced somewhere. And my semester exam is approaching near. So, I need identity card immediately or very badly. So, in this way, in the first paragraph, you state the reason, you state the condition why you need particular document, particular identity card or bona fide certificate or whatever subject may be given. So, in the first paragraph, you should state the reason, background of your need of the subject. In the second paragraph, you also give the assurity to the principal or assurity to the class teacher. In the second paragraph, you should also give the assurity. In this way, you should write, I am ready to provide you all the necessary documents, receipt of the admission or admission receipt. I am also ready to pay the necessary charges of issuing identity card. In this way, you should mention the assurity to the particular authority about issuing the particular document or identity card or letter. And in the third paragraph of main body, you should write, in the third paragraph of letter, you should write, to make such kind of appeal to the related authority. You should make the appeal. You need something as a document badly. And that is why you made a kind of request to the principal or a class teacher or any other authority. So in the third paragraph, you should write here that I hope that you will think positively on my application and issue me identity card as early as possible. I remain thankful from the bottom of my heart. So in this way you should